How's it going, everybody? It's Gorillaman here, back with another Car Mechanic Sim 2021 video. And in today's video, guys, I have got a couple more story missions for us to work on, including this Fair Lady Z that I have not quite worked on yet. I've been saving it just because, honestly, I love to look at it. It looks pretty incredible. But first off, what I'm going to do before I hop into this, I already looked at this a little bit. Before we hop into this, because this is going to be quite a lot of work that's going to be needed to be done to actually get this thing up and running. It's pretty bad. There's 8 pages of things you need to fix, and there's, what is it, 11 or 12 pieces per work order. So yeah, it's 88 things we're going to have to change in that. So I'm going to wait on that just for now. It's like all the suspension, the entire motor, I'm pretty sure has to be ripped out and redone. So we're going to wait, and I'm going to actually take us on our very, very first barn find. I have quite a few barn finds ready to go, so I'm pretty excited about this. So, okay, let's drive there. It costs 100 credits to go. So I've never been on a barn find before. I've never looked at it. I've never searched it. I've just seen pictures from the pre-release, and that's all I've seen. So I'm super, super excited, because barn finds were one of my most favorite things in 2018 Car Mechanic. Okay. Okay. Just gonna take a quick look. It's pretty quiet. Chieftain, TBX. Okay, I just got an achievement. First time at the countryside. Oh my gosh. An R35 just chilling here. It's the value is gonna be way. Oh my gosh. Buy price is 45K. And it's in generally a pretty good condition. Oh my gosh, that is incredible. All right, there's definitely one more in here. Oh, look at that. The exact same van that we're working on is right here. How much is this one for? 32,000. Oh my gosh. Let's see. I guess I should check the junk piles, because if this is anything like 2018. So I can turn this off. It's really not too dark in here. Yeah, if there's anything like 2018, you can actually find cases and crates in these junk piles. Not too sure so far, though, so I guess I'll check them just in case. I could probably repair some of this stuff and sell it for a good amount of money. Check this. Man, if they don't have any. Wow, that's really cool. I really wanted that. Probably should have waited till I hit that 100K mark I was talking about before we came here, honestly. I do have a couple more, though, so it should be fine. And I don't think there's going to be any shortage of barn finds, really, in the future. No. Come on. Oh, I was going to say. Oh, there it is. Haha, we found the case. Okay, what does this sell for? What is this? V8 Chieftain. Oh, okay. Okay. I think we might buy this. Chieftain. The body's looking really good. Okay, okay. Oh, you can examine it in here. Okay, I'm going to go through and examine everything just to see how this is looking, see if I can repair a lot of this. And I'll be right back with you guys. All right, guys, I went through and I've examined a good majority of this in the examination mode. It's in okay shape overall. Let's see, did that change this at all? So buy price is 22,000. There's no estimated price on here, but I do think this is a worthwhile buy. For 22,000, we might be able to get this thing up and running in this video alone. So I think I want to shoot the shot. I definitely want to buy it. Okay, I got to go here. Buy. Send it to the garage. All right, and then we will go back home and we will take our $200 case with us, 190 after the discount. I wonder if we actually have a discount. I don't know if we have a discount on buying things from the junkyard. I think we do. Yeah, we do. Also just got an achievement, Hidden Treasure. All right, so this is the first car that I own in this game so far. Chieftain TBX, I need to remember that. We also got these two still working on, but yeah, this is what we're working with so far. See, the frames, it's definitely in pretty decent condition. Look, I could already sell this for 24K and profit 2,000 credits. So what I'm thinking is we get this as good as we can, and at the end of the video, we sell it to see what we can make out of it. And I think that'll give me a good idea of what we can accomplish in this new version of Car Mechanic. So let me give it a good wash. I doubt the wash is going to increase the price at all. It's usually just body part related. Oh, we got some clean paint underneath this. Wow, okay. Give it a good interior detail. Wow, I guess that being kept in the barn actually paid off. Wow, yeah, this thing is almost mint on the inside at least. And exterior, that's pretty crazy. All right, so I don't think we're gonna even mess this. This is a 69, by the way. 25,000. Did that price go up a little bit? I think it did actually. All right, so what I'm thinking first is we try and get this thing to start. So no BD port, engine needs to be complete. Well, we can do a multimeter test on it at least. There we go. I do know. Okay, wow. Yeah, all the electronics are fried on this, looks like. I did see it's missing a fuel filter. It's missing a couple exhaust pieces. It's missing a head over here. Our head cover. I'm just looking, though. Let's see. Okay, I think I know what I'm gonna do. I think we're gonna start with everything fuel related. Take out everything fuel and spark related. Oh, I thought I got that. And we're gonna see what we can repair. Give me the distributor rotor. Give me the distributor alternator. Gotta get restart or gotta get changed. Put in all new spark plugs. Let's see. Suspension, I'm just gonna leave for now. Get a new filter in here. Let me see. Yeah, all these spark plugs are bad. I'll add in probably one, or I think I need two more rocker arms, what it looks like, or one more rocker arm. All right, so grab the rocker arm really quick. All right, we got the rocker arm. Let's go back to the electronics. Let's get our spark plugs. This is a V8, so I'm gonna buy, oh no, six, geez, eight. Brand new spark plugs. I want to try and give this thing no reason to struggle to start. So I want to give it all of the fuel and air mixture it needs to get going and see if I can actually get it to start turn over on me. I think even if part of the compression is completely gone, in 2018, you could get it to turn over. I'm not saying it's going to be pretty, but it'll be something. All right. Wow. This is my first time I've ever had to buy, like, radiator parts and cooling parts. I also need to buy a power steering reservoir. Let's see. What else? Okay, windshield washer. What else did I see? I think I saw an ignition coil piece. Ignition coil B, I think is what it was, yeah. All right, well, what I pulled out so far, I wanna see if any of this is repairable. Okay, so this is pretty good here. As long as I can actually repair these without messing up, that's good. The corner ones are really easy to hit. See, that cost me 0 credits. That cost me 2 credits. 1 credit. And back. Oh, that was close. So yeah, I think generally repairing Oh, that was a close one. No. Oh, okay. I get another shot. I didn't know if it completely destroyed it. It's just you get another shot and it loses some durability. There we go. Awesome. So there's some parts repaired all the way back. Yeah, this is definitely a pretty sparse. Nope, I need to take all these out. Okay, we're gonna buy all new fuses. All new fuses, all new relays. Like I said, I do not want to give this any reason whatsoever to not start on me. Oh my gosh. Okay, I was like, those fuses are tiny. All right, this is an electric part, so I'm not too sure if I can repair it. But I can. That's awesome. Give me those corner ones. Awesome. There we go. All right, so let's see. What do we need? So I'm gonna add, I know I said I don't need that, but I'm gonna add all of these to the shopping list. Add an alternator and a new carb also. Let's hit the shopping list up. Let's see here. So there's relay B, C. We need three type A's. These are pretty expensive, but I think we should return all of the money on our investment here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. We'll also grab an alternator while we're in here. We're only at about 15K left, which is pretty good. We need a round air filter, but I'm not sure which one it was. Single carb. All right, let's get the fuse box put back in. Our distributor is still pretty bad. Let me go find one of those really quick. Buy a brand new distributor, 60 some bucks. I'm sure we'll get our money back on that. And then right here, I know we were missing some stuff, but I think we got it all. Oh, okay, that's 43. I need to change. So we need fuse B and C. Oh, nope. There we go. All right, let's grab our fuse. Fuse B and fuse C. So we got purple, tan, and red. Alrighty. I think these wires are pretty bad shape, so I'll wait on those. Yeah, okay, so we need V8 wires and we need engine cover head. Which is this. Engine head cover. What am I doing? And it was A for V8 overhead valve. Okay, looking for V8 overhead valve. A V8 overhead valve. There it is. All right, get this bad boy threaded back on there. And then I think we have an almost completed engine. Just gotta put new wires in, new filter in. So, oh, I'm missing a top for a single carb. So unless this thing is completely trashed, like thrown rod bearing or something like that, like absolutely like horrendous, this should start over, I think. Let's look for our battery. And what else am I missing? Was I missing a brake booster, I believe. Match the brake cylinder in here. Battery. So now, really, I think here in the front, all it needs is its coolant. Oh, we need fuse box cover. Guess that's probably in here, eh? It is. All right, and I think the front end is pretty well put back together, I think, except for one part. I think it's the fuel filter, right? Oh, and our alternator, yeah. Our serpentine belt put on 31% shouldn't give me too big of a problem. Let's see. Okay, and then I'm spelling this correctly. Fuel. Two, three, four. And let me sneak this last filter in. Alright. I'm going to. Oh, there is no. There's no oil pan on there. Oil. This is a V overhead valve. And this is a V overhead valve pan. I was about to pour oil in there, and that would have been a big mess. Also, it appears I'm missing crankshaft bearing cap. Let's see, one rod cap, two rod cap, three, four caps. Okay, okay, okay. I think I got an idea. Give me this. Four of those. All right, I'm not going to take out the full piston, but maybe me changing out some of these pretty rough looking caps may help. They're at 27%, which isn't, I don't think that's almost, I don't think that's critical failure yet. I think they have to be red for them to like, yeah, see, that's still orange. I think they got to be like 15 or lower. Give this one a spray. Yeah, that one's bad. That one right there was pretty bad. Yeah, these are definitely a lot nicer looking than the old ones. Although this piston right here in cylinder two or whatever is looks pretty good. Same with what looks like cylinder, I don't even know, seven? Next, you got 2, 4, 6, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7 right here. Unless it's odds. Is it all? I think it's odds on the left, evens on the right. I can't remember how it goes usually. All right. Oil pan can be put on. I think probably it hasn't had any oil in it in quite a few years. And then down here, we're missing exhaust pipe. Oh, I can just add that to the shopping. Add that to the shopping. That's pretty convenient. Yeah, they've definitely outdone themselves. Oops. Definitely outdone themselves with their new shopping list functionality, I should say. It works very, very well. Make sure I got everything coming up into the headers here. I'm gonna pop this starter off, see if I can repair it and put it back on. And then also let me hop to the fuel tank, drop this old fuel tank out. There's no need for me to try and reuse that. It's never really works well for me. Okay, fuel pump. All right, let's see if I can repair this part. I wish there was a repair table out there, but oh, there I can. Awesome. Easy, let's go. And I can repair some rod caps too. That's impressive. That's surprising. I'm probably just going to repair all this stuff and just hold on to it. And then if I really don't want it, like these like a random rod cap or whatever, I could just, since it's, I think, a perfect condition or whatever, I should probably sell it. But if it were to be really, really bad condition, I can scrap it and turn it into scrap to upgrade stuff later. All right, let's get this starter put on. All right. Okay. So after a little look around here, I think we might be able to get this bad boy going. We'll start with oil, power steering, coolant, and windshield, and then brake. We'll get all the fluids in. Make sure she ain't running dry. Okay. Get this in. And good. Third one. I've never heard this one. Power steering, hydraulic fluid, premium high performance. Okay. By Quebec. All right, washing fluid. We don't really need this right now, but just in case, you know. And last but not least, our brake fluid. DOT 3, definitely not 4, but I guess this is 3 and 4, whatever. Okay, so I am fully expecting this to start. Not well, but rocky. Yeah, it'd be very rocky. Oh, also, I think I just realized we are missing a windshield. I think it's just a windshield though, right? Yes, I'm missing a windshield. Let me pick up a windshield really quick before I try and take this out anywhere. Windshield, $200. All right. Okay. So, this is now worth $31,000. And in about 17 and a half minutes now, I have earned about 8K, which is not too much, but I think for what this is, that's pretty solid. Let's see if she starts up. Oh my gosh, it sounded so close to starting up there. There's a lot of 100% stuff in here. I guess the blocks could be bad. I'm looking here what we got. Yeah, a good majority of this stuff is like 60%. It's gotta be the piston. Power steering, probably not, that's not stopping it. It's gotta be the pistons, rod caps, rocker arms, maybe valve push rods. Maybe the water pump. That is a pretty bad water pump. Hey, you know what? I'm gonna try the water pump really quick. It could be all in vain, but I'm gonna give this one more try. See if I lose my coolant by doing this. You would normally lose a lot of your coolant. Yep. That's pretty impressive that they actually changed that. Here, let me go inside really quick. If I can save myself $120 by repairing the water pump. Yes. That is such... Oh, I can't even go out that door. That is such a neat feature. I really like that like repairing feature they have there. Honestly, the only thing I think can think of here would probably be replacing, if this doesn't work per se, it would be replacing, probably starting with the valves, and then the, definitely, yeah, so valve push rods, rocker arms, if that doesn't work, maybe just everything on the front timing side. Oh, we definitely need some coolant in there. Not want to run this dry, run it hot, I guess. Not dry, but run it hot. Does this cost? I think coolant costs us, doesn't it? So it's $50 because we forgot to drain it. $14 to add. Okay. All right, come on. Dang. Okay. Well, it looks like this thing has just got a couple too many problems in it that I just really don't have the time to go through right now and try and switch them out. I mean, that spark, we got fuel, we got good air. The carb looks honestly pretty good. I guess now that it can start and it's complete engine, let's do a compression test on it. Okay, yeah. So we got a really bad piston ring, which I'm pretty sure will stop us, and we have a pretty bad camshaft, which will also stop us. So looks like those are the problems that this thing has, but this was just a barn find. It was supposed to be just a quick flip, pretty much. I mean, it looks gorgeous. I got it fully assembled. I guess if someone else really wants to put a little bit more work into it, they can get it started. I shouldn't probably say a little bit more. If someone wants to tear the motor out and redo it, they can have a try at it. But we're gonna call this one. We're gonna ship it on its way because I'm pretty proud of this. Let's see, 165,000. Pretty generally good interior, 100% frame, 85 body, 72 parts, 50. That's not too bad, honestly. Doesn't start up, but that's all right because this is now worth 31,000. We bought it for 22. I think we bought it for 22.9. It was listed 24, but I think we got 5% off. And yeah, 8,500 profit. That's pretty good. So boom. Now I'm at $44,000. What does this thing have need to do to it? Oh, just refill some stuff. But yeah, no, it's that's pretty crazy. I just also got an achievement, little steps for things going above 40K. But yeah, guys, I think we're gonna end it here. I'm definitely gonna start switching up the videos a little bit. Probably more barn finds, more junkyard finds, probably some lower end vehicles like the Chieftain TBX there. And then as we slowly tick our way up into the 100,000, 200,000, 300, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, or not 10, a million, we'll start working on some crazier stuff. My first rebuild that I want to fully rebuild and keep, I think, is probably gonna be a Fairlady Z like this one. This is a DLC Nissan car. And if I could buy this off the customer right now, what's the price? It does not tell me, does it? Well, if I could buy this off the customer right now, I would. I love the color. I love the body style. I love everything about it. But there we go, guys. If you guys enjoyed the video, leave a like and comment down below. Let me know what you guys were thinking. Let me know if you guys have done a barn find or do you guys have found anything cooler than what I found in mine. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and I'll see you in the next Car Mechanic Simulator video. Peace. I can't believe I'm so tough, and I'm gonna take a trail in the world. I can't believe